एंड टेम्परेचर क्लास 7th चैप्टर 6 फर्स्ट पार्ट। यस गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रंस, नाउ वी विल स्टार्ट चैप्टर 6 हीट एंड टेम्परेचर। हीट एंड टेम्परेचर बोथ टर्म्स यू आर फैमिलियर विद। इन द प्रीवियस क्लासेस आई थिंक यू हैव लर्न्ड अबाउट हीटिंग अ सब्सटेंस कैन कॉज अ चेंज इन इट्स स्टेट and some processes such as evaporation, condensation, melting and freezing, they involve a transfer of heat and the heating causes the expansion of materials. Children, before starting chapter, I will tell you something. We prefer wearing certain clothing in hot weather and other types of clothing in cold or in rainy weather. Children, you know what we wear in the hot weather, in cold weather or in rainy weather. Now, we have to do this activity. Look at the items of clothing in the picture below. Write H for hot and C for cold in the boxes below each picture to identify the weather in which these clothes are worn. The first cloth item, it will be worn in hot weather, second will in cold weather, third in the hot, fourth one in the cold, fifth this also in the cold, and sixth in the hot weather. So what is it that makes us feel hot or cold? We have to find about it. Children, now the topic is heat. We feel hot in summer, and nowadays it is summer going on. So we feel hot and sweat a lot, and we feel cold in winter. A cup of tea, when you touch it, it feels warm. Whereas ice cream cup, when you touch it, it feels cold. The hotness or coldness that we sense, this is due to the differences in heat. Now heat, this is a form of energy. And some important characteristics of heat that we will discuss below. First thing is how hot or cold an object is depends on how much heat energy it contains. If an object contains high amount of heat, then it feels hot. And if it contains low amount of heat, then it feels cold. And heat can be transferred from one object to another. Heat, this is transferred from an object which is hotter to the colder object. And when heat flows into an object, then it becomes warmer. When heat flows out of an object, then it becomes cooler. Children, in daily life, you feel many examples of it. When a spoon is dipped in a hot cup of milk, then the spoon also becomes warm. So, because the heat transferred from the hot milk into the spoon. And when the hot milk, this is placed at the room temperature, then after some time it becomes cooler. Children, when a hot object and a cold object are placed in contact with each other, then heat always flows from hotter object to the colder one. And this continues until both objects reach the same temperature. Temperature. We can tell that one object is hotter or colder than another when we touch them, but we cannot say exactly how hot or cold they are. Our sense of touch is also not very reliable, as demonstrated in the activity. Children, meaning of it is that by touching an object, we can't tell its temperature, whether it is at 15 degree, 20 degree or 25 degree Celsius. Now the activity this help you to understand. Aim to check if we can use our sense of touch to determine how hot or cold an object is. For this activity, materials required 3 beakers labeled as A, B and C. Warm water, cold water and water at room temperature. Children, the warm water should be only slightly warm and not so hot that it causes a burn. Now, method is, first of all, take 3 beakers labeled A, B and C. Label it with the help of marker. Now pour some warm water in beaker A, cold water in beaker C, and water at room temperature in beaker B. Place beaker B in the middle. Now dip the index finger of your left hand in beaker A and index finger of your right hand in beaker C simultaneously, means together, for about 2 minutes. Now your left hand will feel warm and your right hand will feel cold. After 2 minutes, now dip both index fingers into the water in beaker B. Now observation. You will observe that the water in beaker B feels cold to your left hand and water to your right hand. You will observe that the water in the beaker B, this feels cold to your left hand and this feels warm to your right hand. Now conclusion, the terms hot and cold, these are relative. Our sense of touch is not reliable in determining how hot or cold an object is. Now for an accurate determination, if we want to find exactly how hot or cold an object is, we measure temperature and the degree of hotness or coldness of an object. So this is called its temperature. An object is at a higher temperature, this is hotter, and contains more heat than an object at a lower temperature.